Grace,
Hi.
if you could just say your name and affiliation and pay attention to your group chat for the timing cues, we could start.
I'm very responsible. You'll be happy to know. Grace Randolph, Beyond the Trailer.
Grace, how are you? You're
Hi.
somewhere back. Are you on the East Coast?
Yes, I am. It's nighttime here.
Right.
And I have to say, I'm a big Judge Dredd fan, by the way.
Oh, Red. Oh, thank you very much.
And so, Karl, I have to say, you deliver some really intense long strings of profanity. Are
Yeah.
you doing it from the script or do you improvise? And do you ever break? Do you ever laugh?
Listen, 75% of what you hear Billy Butcher say is what's on the page, and the rest of it is just extra spice, extra mayonnaise for the salad, and we certainly like lots of flavor, and I feel like it's my duty to make sure that there's plenty of good tastes going around.
It's quite flavorful, I will
Yeah.
agree. Now, I have to say, the whale scene.
Yes.
Wow.
Yeah.
Very detailed and graphic. There's a heart in there. You guys are drenched in blood. What was it like filming that scene?
We went and had sushi afterwards.
We did, didn't we?
We did. We did.
You really did?
We did.
Oh, that's fantastic.
Karen picked the restaurant. No, it was hot. It was tight, small, cramped quarters. It was sticky. It was wet. It was red everywhere in your body. You can imagine red could be under your fingernails and everywhere else. And it was freaking amazing. It was great. It was like,
Was it really though? I don't know if it was that great. To me, it felt like a 2 week bloody facial that
I would say probably by day five, it wasn't so great.
How many
Yeah.
days did you film that scene?
Oh, 14 days.
Oh.
14, like this director, he would bring us in, put us in the 2 hour makeup each, and might shoot 30 minutes and be like, all right, let's move on to something else. And we're like, okay. So I would say we worked a lot that episode. We worked a lot.
Wow. Well, also, I have to say, already just three episodes in, I can't believe it. Huey is challenging Butcher for leadership. And I
That's
can't, what's even more shocking is he's actually making headway.
right.
What do you think is it causing that shift?
Well, I mean, here's the thing. At the end of season one, Billy Butcher turned his back on the boys in order to go on some mad cat revenge caper. And when you make a bad choice, you get punished for it in the world of the boys, as is often in life. Coming into season two, Billy Butcher's position as the unchallenged leader of the group is definitely being questioned, and rightfully so. Billy Butcher's main drive for season two is to get his wife back, and he needs the boys to do it. But things are going to have to get addressed and dealt with before that's going to happen.
Laz, why do you think your character is willing to even consider switching to Huey?
I don't think it's necessarily switching to Huey as much as it is keeping Butcher accountable. And I feel like that's what Mother's Milk is attempting to do throughout the season, is to keep him grounded and to keep him accountable. Not necessarily, to me or to Frenchie, but primarily to himself and the contract that he made with Huey. They made an agreement, he brought him on, and you can't just walk out of that. He's your responsibility now. And so that was pretty much the consciousness that Mother's Milk approached Butcher with when they would have those very strong moments. And some were actually, to me, I felt they were very friendship-driven moments, where they were where Butcher, in a low voice, would admit things to Mother's Milk that he could never admit to the rest of the boys. And because he knew that don't bullshit me. Let's keep it real. And they have that relationship. So to me, it's a relationship built on a mutual respect that translates both off and on screen. And it's a pleasure to play. I love all the scenes that we got to play this year.
Yeah, I do too. There's just a real wonderful dynamic that was explored between MM and Butcher this season. And you really come to understand that MM is in many ways a voice of conscience for Butcher. And as you discover through the season, probably the character that, aside, Becker aside, that Butcher trusts the most. And, you know, you really come to understand why Butcher brought MM back and why he needs him so, so desperately.
Yeah, Butcher's got a canary and a Jiminy Cricket. Thank you
Jiminy
so much.
Cricket.
Yeah, that's you.
I like it.